Tickets to My Downfall by Machine Gun Kelly, the fifth studio album from the Cleveland rapper, which apparently is something that I wasn't expecting, and I'm pretty sure a lot of people weren't expecting. It's a really a different album than, you know, pretty much every other project that MGK has dropped. I know what you guys are thinking. God damn, Eminem did this boy so fucking dirty that MGK deadass went from rap to pop punk. You know, he just straight up switched fucking genres because he was like, fuck it, I guess I just got that beat that I'm not allowed to be a rapper anymore. All jokes aside, I am personally glad to say that MGK did not sneak this Eminem in this album like he did in Hotel Diablo and like he did in the whole fucking Binge EP. You know, I'm so glad that, you know, they're not gonna do this whole back and forth shit anymore. You know, to be honest, the whole beef was very fucking petty. And yes, as a big Eminem fan, I am saying it was a petty fucking beef. You know, it's whatever, you know, just a bunch of, you know, sneak this. But thankfully, you know, there is no sneak this into Eminem here. And it's really great to see MGK move on with his career and his life and just, you know, getting, you know, get more focused on getting back on track with his career. So, like I said, Machine Gun Kelly surprises the hell out of all of us as he trades his signature Cleveland rap style with this early 2000s era punk style, which, to be honest, is not too bad. You know, obviously Machine Gun Kelly does know how to play guitar. You know, his guitar skills are really fucking dope considering that he has been practicing ever since quarantine happened. You know, he's been practicing a little bit extra this year in particular. But obviously he still like wanted a little bit of extra help with the production value to make sure that the end product was really great, or, you know, at least a bit like decent, you know. And who else to get help with the production value than none other than Blink-182's Travis Barker. Now, lately it seems in recent projects that Machine Gun Kelly has dropped, he has always had, you know, this sort of like negative view on fame, which, to be fair, I think every rapper and just every artist in general like always has this negative view on fame. But they obviously don't like talking about it because, you know, then they'll, you know, be seen as like, you know, like these selfish crybabies who have it all and are still bitching about their lives. Which, to be fair, I do think they kind of have a right to, because if I had to deal with a bunch of asshole paparazzis, I'd probably be losing my shit as well. But it seems that lately Machine Gun Kelly has always like had this negative view on fame, and, you know, and it's mostly because of the fact that he pretty much feels that, you know, most fans don't really care about, you know, an artist, you know, succeeding, and feels that more people like get more interested and, you know, give more attention when they see an artist's downfall. You know, the whole idea that people really love to see a lot of people suffer. You know, we as human beings are sadistic as fuck. You know, we're all pieces of shit, we're all terrible, and we all deserve to fucking be killed by Mother Nature because we have no redeeming qualities, because we are just shit fucking human beings. So since people have such a huge desire to want to see the downfall of an artist and just see an artist fall apart, MGK gives them exactly that, as he pretty much says fuck you to everybody who does want to purchase a ticket to his downfall, because here it is, his downfall. And, you know, I guess it's sort of like a metaphor of, like, you know, it's not really his downfall because he is, you know, like trying to show that he will rise above and everything. But personally, this project is kind of a hit or miss for me. This project is filled with nothing but fuck you moments, a lot of angsty lyrics, like I think a lot more fucking angsty than how it was back then. Well, I guess not that bad, because to be honest, you know, back then it was like super fucking foul and angsty, and, you know, this is just, you know, Machine Gun Kelly just sort of like dipping his toes and trying to be like an angsty like pop punk artist. And just overall, this album is just filled with, you know, a lot of like proud moments as MGK, you know, is still living that reckless life that he's been living since the start of his fucking career, pretty much. Now, to be fair, I do think that Machine Gun Kelly is a pretty decent rapper. You know, I always felt that he was a decent rapper. You know, it's the reason why he is, you know, one of my favorite artists. You know, despite the fact that my favorite rapper is Eminem and the fact that they had this whole beef, but that's a whole like another story. But I always did think that he was a decent rapper, you know, at least when he cares. When I first heard the Lace Up album, you know, it wasn't that I felt that, you know, was a bit disappointed. And it's just that at the time, I think MGK was still sort of a kid, you know. I think he was like barely like 19 or, you know, 18, you know, somewhere around that age. So obviously he was just having fun, which I could appreciate, you know. I personally don't like always judge an artist on their first like studio album, because you know it's the like formal introduction to their music to the world, and you know you can't really you know judge them on that, because it's them like sort of trying out, you know. And for the most part, you know it's not always the case, but for the most part, not that many rappers, you know, first studio album, you know, ends up being their best project, because they end up making a bunch of other studio albums that pretty much, you know, make that first studio album look like fucking ass. And that's when we get to MGK's second studio album, General Admission, which to this day I personally still believe it is the best project that MGK has ever dropped so far. You know, it is my personal favorite project from him. You know, I can hear this album without any skips every time I hear it. You know, it's that much of a good album. You know, he really like tests his lyrical rage. You know, he's obviously improved a lot with his metaphors and everything. And, you know, he obviously added like so much like diversity to this album. And, you know, it's just something that, you know, it's just something that I always like appreciated. And, you know, it's definitely an album that is, you know, worthy in his discography. And then we go a bit downhill with his third studio album, Bloom. And if we wanted to keep talking about downhill, I personally didn't like the Binge EP either. You know, these two projects were some of the most, you know, disappointing, you know, projects that MGK has ever dropped. Granted, Binge is still like a lot more better than Bloom. You know, Bloom was just an all over the place sort of like, what the fuck is this man doing sort of album. You know, I honestly did not know what the fuck was going on. You know, I did not know what the fuck happened. You know, I was personally like so disappointed when I first heard Bloom. And as for Binge, but you know, I guess I kind of do like the whole Party Animal, you know, sort of vibe, but I just personally did not care too much about the whole, you know, sneak diss and Eminem shit. You know, it was something that was just getting super fucking repetitive at that point, because, you know, although I did appreciate the Rap Devil diss track, you know, I feel it is one of the greatest diss tracks to ever be made to Eminem, you know, I just felt that, you know, after that, it just got super fucking repetitive. Like we get it. You're pissed off that this man, you know, mentioned you once in his fucking new album. Like, get the fuck over it. And then about a year later since Binge, we got last year's Hotel Diablo, his fourth studio album, which, in my opinion, it is the best project that this man has dropped since General Admission. You know, it's actually my second favorite album by Machine Gun Kelly. You know, I really love how, you know, he got super vulnerable in that one. You know, it was a really personal like album. You know, he talks about, you know, loss. You know, he opens up and shows a lot of maturity. And, you know, I felt that there is nowhere to go but up from here, because I feel that that MGK has finally found his style and his, you know, like sort of like his sort of sound that would make people, you know, want to say, fuck yeah, I really fuck with MGK and I'm not embarrassed to show it. So I've obviously been used to hearing MGK like rap a lot, that the fact that he changed to this whole like different genre, you know, and just made a straight up, you know, pop punk album, you know, was something super unexpected for me at least. You know, and like I said, I don't think that the album sounds bad. You know, I personally think MGK does have quite the voice for it. You know, there are some, you know, songs where, you know, he is just trying too hard and you can fucking tell. But for the most part, I do think he does have quite the voice for it. You know, MGK definitely did well at taking us back to that really strange era and time of music, and just a really strange time in general, which was the early 2000s. Listen, y'all, I personally love reminiscing on the early 2000s as much as the next guy does, but even I can admit that that era was fucking shit sometimes. You know, like, not only was the music kind of garbage, but you know, the fucking movies were a big garbage too. I mean, don't get me wrong, I love the Tobey Maguire movies. I think Tobey Maguire was one of the greatest Spider-Man's, you know, regardless of the ridiculous shit they made him do in those movies. But you know, are those movies the best movies? Fuck no. Okay, those movies did not age fucking well. You know, I look back on all the Spider-Man movies that Tobey Maguire did, and honestly, I cringe so bad because of just how fucking ridiculous they fucking are. This album just sounds as if MGK never went through his emo phase, like when he was younger, and he like pretty much decided that, you know what, fuck it, I'm gonna go through it now because why the fuck not? Which let me just say, there is nothing wrong with that. There is nothing wrong with liking, you know, emo music. You know, I think, you know, everyone is entitled to liking their own kind of music. It's just the fact that MGK decided that he wanted to bring back the early 2000s era into modern day times, you know, I just have to wonder, you know, why would he do that? Because, you know, like I said, it was a really weird time in music, and a lot of people today would say that, you know, it's like one of the cringiest time in the world. And, you know, if he was gonna bring it back, at least he could like made it sound better. But, you know, it just, you know, A lot of these tracks just sounded like super fucking generic. And, you know, I do understand that he's trying, and I do appreciate the effort that he put in. But, you know, that's the reason why I was personally finding a hard time fully enjoying this project. You know, I personally didn't want to shit on the guy because he went from rap to pop punk. You know, I think it's really great for an artist who wants to expand himself, you know, beyond hip hop and beyond, you know, the same old shit that he or she has been doing. It's just the fact that, you know, I don't think he chose the right era to do that with this project. However, the reason why this album is a bit enjoyable for me is, first of all, the production value that is done by Travis Barker. You know, he never disappoints. You know, he's done many things with, you know, Yellow Wolf and the Suicide Boys. You know, he just always manages to like make a lot of like shit sound good, you know, whether it be with rap or whether it be with like country style rap. You know, he just always like finds a way to make it sound good. And another reason why this album sounded pretty well to me was the guest list. You know, even though it's a bit small, you know, the guest list is a reason why I felt that this album was pretty enjoyable for me, at least. The fifth track, entitled Forget Me Too, has the guest feature with none other than Halsey herself, which I personally was surprised. I did not think Halsey and MGK were gonna do a song together, because I know like this whole beef with him and G-Eazy, but I guess it's okay now because I recently heard that MGK and G-Eazy have finally squashed their beef, so you know, that's good at least. But I was just super surprised to see Halsey and MGK here, because I didn't think that, you know, they ended on good terms. But I guess they did, because they came back for this track, even though it kind of sounds like they're kind of throwing shit at each other. You know, it's sort of like, you know, the lyrics consists of, you know, MGK talking about, you know, this girl that, you know, wants to forget everything about him. They, you know, fuck it, he'll forget about her too. You know, it just feels like they're both like sort of throwing shit at each other, because it's just this like angry, you know, heartbreak song that sounds like something fucking Avril Lavigne would have fucking done back when she was the fucking princess of pop punk. You know, it was just, you know, it just once again gives us that classic, you know, like early 2000s era, you know, pop punk style that was good. You know, I'm not gonna say all of it, you know, was good back in the early 2000s, but there were a bit exceptions that made it sound good, and the reason why it's to this day is still like just as enjoyable. And then we get to the sixth track, entitled All I Know, which has a feature with none other than Trippie Redd himself, somebody who really loves exploring rock music. In fact, he has always said that rock music is the reason why he decided to be in the music industry in general, which I always find surprising to see, because Trippie Redd doesn't really make like what I would consider rock music. But then again, I don't really hear much of his albums, so I might be wrong. You know, maybe he does do shit like that. But I can really see the inspiration of rock music and Trippie Redd's voice in this song, at least. You know, I think it's one of the few tracks where I can really tolerate Trippie Redd. Like I said, Trippie Redd is a really hit or miss artist for me, because when it comes to all of these, you know, like emo, you know, rappers that suddenly like rose to the fucking top out of nowhere, I feel that Trippie Redd like stands out the most, because he does know how to work well with that genre, and you know how to like really like make it sound good, and the reason why a lot of people do love him. But I feel that there are times where Trippie Redd makes a really dumb and mediocre song with his like stupid ass voice, and then there are times where he takes himself a lot more seriously, and that's when you can really enjoy him. And thankfully, he did take himself a lot more seriously in this album with MGK. You know, they both become super fucking vulnerable. You know, they fucking like, they just like go fucking hard, and you know, they just go in general, and you know, once again gives us that angry, you know, pop punk, you know, like vibe. You know, I really love the aggressiveness, and I just really love how well, you know, MGK and JP Red, you know, work well with their voices. You know, they both sounded so unique from each other. You know, it's a really like different duo that you wouldn't think would work out well, but somehow it did, and I'm totally okay with it. And finally, the 11th track, which is probably my favorite track out of the whole album, entitled My Ex's Best Friend, which includes a feature with none other than Black Bear himself, who has been impressing the fuck out of me lately. Not only did he drop that really great project last year called Anonymous, which was a fucking, you know, roller coaster full of sadness, you know, fuck you Black Bear for making me sad as fuck with that album, but thank you for giving me one of the best R&B projects last year. But he also made another impressive album this year, entitled Everything Means Nothing. You know, I ended up once again enjoying every track on there, and I ended up enjoying his voice a lot more in this track than I did with MGK, which I guess I'm kind of mad that Black Bear like didn't really get like that much of a good verse in this particular song. You know, I think he's in there for like maybe a good 20 seconds, and then MGK, you know, takes over the rest of the song. You know, I'm not saying that MGK, you know, didn't sound nice, because I do think it's one of the few tracks where I think his voice like did like work well with the, you know, early 2000s era pop punk vibe that he was trying to do. But I just wish he would have given Black Bear like a much more like bigger like spotlight, because I think he's a super underrated and really talented artist, and you know, it just really shows the like amount of shit he can do. Not only can he work with like rap beats and, you know, like just, you know, like creepy ass, you know, R&B vibes, but now he can work well with pop punk vibes, and you know, it just really shows the true potential that Black Bear has. And I would definitely be down to hear Black Bear try to attempt a style like this, because I think he'd work really well for it. Honestly, the reason why I'm not being too harsh on Machine Gun Kelly in this album is because I like to think of this album as Machine Gun Kelly's Flower Boy. Flower Boy by Tyler the Creator was an album that came out back in 2017. As Tyler the Creator pretty much wanted to explore beyond the typical sort of like angry, like, you know, like pissed off teenager rap style that he's been doing, and pretty much wanted to dip his toes into something different. And although I don't think that Flower Boy was his best project, I do give him props for the effort that he wanted to do, because after that project, he would come out with the impressive Igor, which is one of the best projects that he's dropped in a fucking while. And you know, it was pretty much the style that he was trying to do for Flower Boy, only he managed it to achieve it a lot more better on that project. So that's why I'm giving, you know, MGK a bit of a pass and, you know, a bit of a break, because I do think that this is him pretty much dipping his toes and into trying to do, you know, a different genre like other than rap. So I'm just hoping, and you know, I am positive and optimistic that, you know, the next, you know, pop punk project that MGK does, if he does, you know, decide to do it, is gonna turn out a lot more better than this project, and I'm probably going to enjoy a lot more than this. So props to you, MGK. I can see that you're trying, and you know, I do appreciate it. And you know, just, you know, good luck on any other, you know, pop punk project that you want to do, because I have no doubt that you will know like what to do, and you'll be able to achieve it a lot more better. Thank you all so much for watching. If you guys enjoyed my review, don't forget to like, subscribe, click the button below, all that good stuff, and don't forget to stay happy. You know my ex, so that makes it all feel complicated, yeah. It all seems complicated. I read those texts that you sent to your